Ladies and gentlemen, will you please rise for the graduating class of 2024?
Please be seated. Beloved is Where We Begin by Jan Richardson. If you would enter into the wilderness, do not begin without a blessing. Do not leave without hearing who you are, beloved, named by the one who has traveled this path before you. Do not go without letting it echo in your ears. And if you find it is hard to let it into your heart, do not despair. This is what this journey is for. I cannot promise this blessing will free you from danger, from fear, from hunger or thirst, from the scorching of sun or the fall of the night, but I can tell you that on this path, there will be help. I can tell you that on this way, there will be rest. I can tell you that you will know the strange graces that come to our aid only on a road such as this, that fly to meet us bearing comfort and strength, that come alongside us for no other cause than to lean themselves toward our ear. And with their curious insistence, whisper our name. Beloved, beloved, beloved.
Belonging by Rosemary Watala Tomer. As if it were true, we are alone. We are alone together. The way blades of grass are alone, but exist as a field. Sometimes I feel it, the green fuse that ignites us, the wild thrum that unites us, an inner hum that reminds us of our shared humanity. Just as 35 trillion red blood cells join one body to become one blood. Just as 136,000 notes make up one symphony. Alone as we are, our small voices weave into the big conversation. Our actions are essential to the one infinite story of what it is to be alive. When we feel alone, we become the grand communion of those who sometimes feel alone. We are the dust that hopes, a rising of dust, a thrill of dust, the dust that dances in the light with other dust, the dust that makes the world.
Welcome, friends, family, and class of 2024. We are thrilled to have each of you with us this evening for our annual baccalaureate service. This service is our chance as a Converse community to thank you for all you have been to us, to bless you as you prepare to leave us, and to join you in your excitement as you look toward your next chapter. We are so very proud of you, and we are so glad that you are here. Please rise as you are able and join us in singing our opening hymn, led by Senior Jade Hope. The words are printed in your bulletin.
I hear the rhythm of your love. As we gather today for baccalaureate and tomorrow to celebrate commencement, we acknowledge that there are many within our community grieving the loss of loved ones. As we continue to celebrate this weekend, let us remember and call to mind those beloved family and friends who cannot be with us physically at this time. Please remain standing and join me now in our litany of remembrance by reading the portion entitled Response. In the rising of the sun and in its going down, we remember them. In the blowing of the wind and in the chill of winter, we remember them. In the opening buds and in the rebirth of spring, we remember them. In the blueness of the sky and in the warmth of summer, we remember them. In the rustling of leaves and in the beauty of autumn, we remember them. In the beginning of the year and when it ends, we remember them. When we are weary and in need of strength, we remember them. When we are lost and sick at heart, we remember them. When we have joys we yearn to share, we remember them. So long as we live, they too shall live, for they are now a part of us as we remember them. Please be seated.
Oh, an excerpt from The Growing Edge, the theologian, educator, and civil rights leader, Howard Thurman. The community cannot feed for long on itself. It can only flourish where always the boundaries are giving way to the coming of others from beyond them. Unknown and undiscovered brothers and sisters.
Poem from Rupi Gar. Remember the body of your community. Breathe in the people whose soul you hold. It is you who became yourself, but those before you are a part of your fabric. Honor the roots.
And a reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Indeed, the body does not consist of one member, but of many. If the foot would say, because I am not a hand, I do not belong to the body, that would not make it any less a part of the body. And if the ear would say, because I am not an eye, I do not belong to the body, that would not make it any less a part of the body. If the whole body were an eye, where would the hearing be? If the whole body were hearing, where would the sense of smell be? If all were a single member, where would the body be? As it is, there are many members, yet one body.
Sorry about that. Hello, everybody. My name is Amaya Parkins. From the moment I stepped on campus, the community and familial feeling was all over. At Converse, belonging isn't just a word. It's a feeling, an experience, and a commitment to each other. The best part about going to a small university is that you know everyone. Whether it be highs or lows, you have an immense support system behind you every time. Coming into school here at Converse, I was nervous. All of my high school friends were going to the same 3 to 5 colleges, close to each other, and none of them were going to be college athletes. Despite this, I was determined to find my place at Converse and make the best of my time here. I quickly connected with my women's basketball team teammates and made friends any and everywhere I could, leaning heavily on mentors and various teachers. Not only did I find people to lean on, I became open to becoming other support systems as well. Not even a month ago, I hosted the Out of Darkness Suicide Prevention Walk on campus. This event was a tremendous success with over 300 people in attendance. Not only did my committee and I help raise over $3,000, but we also brought a safe space to campus that opens a hard conversation, making said conversation easier to have. The support from faculty, staff, alumni, students, family, and friends was tremendous and only instilled into me even more that Converse is a big family and nothing less. Being at Converse is being in a village of immense support. I found my place and belonging at Converse by leaning into the support of the community surrounding me, and I wouldn't want it any other way.
Good evening, and welcome, Converse community. My name is Victoria Connor, and I had the honor of serving as the Vice President for the Student Government Association this past year. Throughout the last few weeks of the semester, several people have asked me questions about my experience at Converse. How have I been impacted as a student? What opportunities has Converse offered me? How have I discovered a sense of belonging at Converse? I entered college 4 years ago in the midst of COVID, not knowing what the future would hold for me. Because of the limitations regarding what we were able to do and the ways in which we were able to interact with one another, I struggled to figure out my purpose and where I belong. As I entered into my sophomore, junior, and senior years, I have been given numerous opportunities to get involved make an impact on this campus, and leave my mark. As I sit back and reflect, Converse has provided me with a community and an atmosphere where I feel that I can learn, grow, lead, and most importantly, be myself. Converse University fosters a strong sense of community and has provided opportunities for me to connect with my peers who share similar interests and passions. Through various clubs, organizations, and events, I have been able to continue to develop and enhance my leadership skills to another level. I have found wonderful mentors like Daphne Glenn, Daniel Stone, and Revan Eliza, who have all empowered me to become a confident student leader and have pushed me to my fullest potential. They have been there every step of the way. These three have guided me through tough conversations, helped me through my failures, celebrated my successes, created safe spaces, and given me encouragement when needed. My peers have also played a significant role in my college experience. Serving on the executive committee this past year, I have grown closer to some amazing people. Even when we didn't always agree, we always maintained the utmost level of respect for one another. When we faced obstacles, we took them as learning opportunities. We leaned on and raised each other up, rather than tearing one another down. Being vice president, I have been able to make personal connections with different students from all walks of life to help them implement changes that they would like to see on campus, whether big or small. Through getting to know different people, learning about different cultures, building friendships, and working beside phenomenal student leaders, I have been able to learn more about myself and build long-lasting relationships. Being at Converse has allowed me to experience growth in multiple capacities. As I stand here today, I can look back and see my growth and the impact that I have made on campus. None of this would have been possible if it wasn't for God, my mom, the love and support from my family and friends, and my mentors. Class of 2024, it's been a long 4 years, but we've all overcome our own obstacles and challenges. I'm proud to see how far we've all come and can't wait to see what we accomplish in our future endeavors. Thank you.
When I reflect on my past 4 years here at Converse, there are so many memories and life lessons that I've learned. So as we stand here today, the night before graduation, I thought I'd share a few of these things with you. First off, I want to start out by giving you an image of a quilt. My time at Converse has taught me that life is this quilt. Each little patch that you add to your quilt is a memory, an experience, maybe a friend. You're continuously adding to it. The good thing about a quilt, though, is that you can also take away from it. If a patch doesn't fit, you can reconfigure it someplace else or remove it altogether. There's the first lesson. Don't get too attached to the patches in your life. Sometimes they might not quite fit your quilt, or maybe as you continue to build your quilt, that patch you tried so hard to squeeze onto the side will end up fitting in the most unexpected of places. Another great thing about a quilt is that once you're done, you can look back and admire how far you've come. You can look over your favorite patches and see how well you had sewn them into the pre-existing quilt. And you can look at the patches maybe you struggled with. Sometimes certain patches don't quite fit the vibe of the entire design of your quilt, yet at the same time, they add to the overall collage of patterns that is your life. You have to remember that sometimes the ugliest of patches, in the midst of prettier patches, create a far more unique and interesting collage than a quilt of solely perfect patches. Oh, it's really raining. I remember one of these so-called uglier patch moments at the spring dance last semester that ended up serving as a small life lesson. My friends and I were all ready to go to the winter dance. And then all of a sudden, like today, the rain started pouring down outside the senior apartments. One of my friends, who was herself a senior at the time, looked outside and sighed. This wasn't the senior dance she had envisioned for herself. We all walked outside the car, feeling our hair and makeup melt off under the pounding rain. Then, when we arrived at the dance, which is at Duncan Park, we had to park in the furthest and farthest parking spot possible and trudge up the hill with no umbrellas. This may sound like a long way of getting to my second piece of advice, but when we got out inside, there were two distinct sets of people. One group, their hair soaked, their makeup running, attempted to salvage what was left of their eyeliner and foundation. They were so focused on how their life appeared on the outside that they never even danced at all. The second group, and the group I hope you always choose to be a part of, still had their hair soaked, and yes, their makeup was still running, but instead of letting the rain trample on the joys of life, they embraced it and quite literally danced in the rain. Finally, and most importantly, remember that life is a race and not a sprint. And when you get tired, wrap yourself in your Valkyrie quilt we talked about earlier, get your second wind, then get back up and look towards the sidelines, and there'll be an entire sisterhood of entire family of Converse men and women cheering you forward until you cross the finish line. Well, class of 2024, you have just about, though not quite yet, made it to the finish line of your undergraduate careers. Congratulations. We celebrate with you as a campus, and we need you to know that we will miss you more than you know. In all of our liturgy today, we've thought about what it means to be worthy of belonging. We've used scripture and poetry, communal proclamation, and even testimony to elevate the reality that we as people depend on, challenge, and strengthen one another. This is both our sacred responsibility and one of life's greatest challenges, being in community. The world has taught us from a very early age that things that are alike go together. When we learn to clean up after ourselves as children, we learn to put the crayons together, the chalk together, the paper together, the glue sticks together. Everything went in its place. Everything went where it belonged. As we got older, we learned how to do the dishes. Well, some of you learned to do the dishes. And we learned that we put the bowls together. We put the cups together. We put the forks together. We put the spoons together. Everything went in its place. Everything went where it belonged. As college students, you may have cleaned your dorm room from time to time. I see some no's. But you knew, if you were to, that you would put the shoes together, the socks together, the pants together, the tops together. Everything would go in its place. Everything would go where it belonged. See, we've been taught our whole lives the importance of keeping the drawers tidy. Being organized leads us to efficiency. When everything alike is in one place, there is no rummaging around in the chaos. There is no searching for what is lost or missing. Tidy drawers and cabinets and closets, they make our lives simpler. They make our lives less stressful. But I don't know that we're called to always keep our drawers so tidy. I admit I started to think about this last week when I moved my office next door in Montgomery and I had to clean out my own desk so that it could be moved to the next room.
Those of you who know me well know that organization is not always my strong suit. Chloe is laughing. And by no means am I suggesting that you should abandon all sense of order in your lives. I know my own mother somewhere is watching this, thinking back to the nightmare of my teenage bedroom, but stay with me. I invite you to think about it in this way. If we open a drawer and it only has glue sticks, how will we ever make a whole art project? If we open a cabinet and there are only cups there, how do we eat a whole meal? If we slide the door to our closet and there are only pants, how will we ever make an entire outfit? When the drawers are messy, it is true that it does add chaos to our lives. No doubt that it does lower efficiency for us. It takes away predictability, and sometimes it even produces frustration. But when the drawers are messy, we also open the door for creativity. We open the door for the sacred and the beautiful unpredictability. We might be surprised what we find in there and just where it leads us. Fostering real, authentic, and healthy community means that the drawers, they have to be messy. Real community, community where everyone can belong, means that we make room for folks to show up as their full selves, open to the potential of what they might add to the mix so that we might all be better together. To foster belonging is to accept that only being in relationship with people like us is easier, but it's limiting. Surrendering to messy drawers means that we do give up a sense of control, but at the same time, we gain the building blocks to new and beautiful potential. The truth is, you all, class of 2024, you already know the value of messy drawers. Your time at Converse has been a testament to that. You've been in classes and in clubs and on teams with people who look, think, and act differently than you do. You've learned how to celebrate each other's religious traditions, and you have learned to stand in solidarity with those who are hurting, even when it's for a reason that you might not understand personally. Who is this? Will you leave here and go and be the type of leaders who embrace and even create messy drawers? My hope and my prayer for each of you is that you will go out and be change makers. But I pray that you will do it in messy and diverse and sometimes even chaotic company. I pray that you will do it in community, in complicated and hard and wonderful and beloved community. Your time has come to leave us at 580 East Main Street. You can always, always come home, and we hope that you will. But the truth is, this chapter for you is closing, and you are ready. You have all that you need to be all that you are in this world. So keep growing. Keep asking why. Keep wrestling. Keep challenging. Keep being people that in a broken world dare to embrace the risk of being in relationship across lines of difference. Go make messy, messy drawers. We love you, and you can do it. Amen. Graduates, we ask you to stand and participate if you are able. As we prepare to close this chapter and enter the next, we take a moment to honor those who have helped us this time, help make this time in our lives special. Roommates and friends, teachers and mentors, coaches and administrators and staff, and families near and far. We remember and celebrate the blessings we have known here. Friendships made, celebrations enjoyed, promises kept, intellectual and academic accomplishments, caring and nurture given and received, play and work, study and rest. We remember the journey in all of its fullness. We lift up and honor the challenges we have faced. Moments of grief, times when we felt discouraged, moments of overwhelm, and hard days. We lift up and honor the moments of joy. Times when we felt, believe we could, times of connection, times when we did not feel alone. We hold fast to all that has been transformative in our college chapter. We take what we have learned here and use it for good. Thank you. Please remain standing.
So now we've gotten to the part in our service that is perhaps the most special part. So graduates, I'll ask that you remain standing. This is the part of our service where your friends and family and your faculty and staff get to offer you a blessing. So I'll ask that everyone else please rise. And I ask that you find the part in this liturgy, the blessing of the graduates, that suits you best and participate at the appropriate time. Graduates, there are no words for you to speak here. Simply hear this blessing and receive it. As you all prepare to graduate tomorrow, may you remember that it is as much a commencing, a beginning, as it is an ending. May you carry with you our love and support for all that lies ahead. May you carry with you our belief in your accomplishments and potential as you head into professional work, further study, community service, or time off. May you carry with you our belief in your goodness and hope as you begin building new lives while holding on to the old in this time of transition. May you carry with you your belief in your abilities and character as future leaders in our communities and our greater world. And may you carry with you a strong belief in yourselves as you continue to grow and to learn, to give and to receive. May you go in peace and with joy. We are so very, very proud of you.